Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Bagas here, and today we're gonna be reviewing pretty much the modern version of Walking With Dinosaurs, that is Planet Dinosaur. Not to be confused with Dinosaur Planet, which I've already reviewed. And I say that because I nearly wrote Dinosaur Planet while writing the script. Anyway, since I pretty much have nothing else to say, let's get on with it. Planet Dinosaur is a 6-episode documentary released in 2011, and its main focus is covering the latest scientific discoveries about dinosaurs. The episodes consist of the depictions of the dinosaurs intercut with analytical segments of the real-life discoveries the segments are based on. The first episode is set in Africa and focuses on Spinosaurus, and believe it or not, this is the first documentary that I've reviewed that has a Spinosaurus in it. So yeah, took me long enough. Anyways, I do like how this opening sequence kind of tricks the audience into believing the Spinosaurus is about to hunt the Tyrannosaurus. It's a nice fake out of the usual trope of predatory dinosaurs being mindless killing machines that eat whatever they can find. This documentary instead shows the Spinosaurus hunting fish, which is more accurate. And honestly, it's just really entertaining to see the Spinosaurus hunt Oncopistes while a Rugop scavenges in the background. We then get to see a fight over territory between two Carcharodontosaurus, and later on we see the victor hunting the Oranosaurus. The climax of the episode sees the two large predators fighting over the Oranosaurus carcass in brutal fashion. And I do like how the conflict is spurred from an external force, being, you know, the drought that's occurring, as normally these two would not interact with each other due to them occupying different niches. Unlike the first episode, this one focuses on a bunch of different places and time periods. We started in a Jurassic forest observing an Epidexiteryx, I'm pretty sure I pronounced that right, as it hunts for bugs, avoiding a sin raptor, and getting its food stolen by a larger individual. We then jump to the Mongolian desert to witness an old raptor raiding a Saurornithoides nest, and then a Gigantoraptor eating the Saurornithoides. God damn it, why are these names so hard to pronounce? We also get to see the Gigantoraptor performing a mating display and fighting off a rival. The final part focuses on Microraptor, and I like how there's a chase scene that initially starts with the Microraptor chasing a gliding lizard that then ends up with the Microraptor itself being chased by a Synornithosaurus, in which the Microraptor barely escapes. And I like how this chase scene depicts the different fields both similar dinosaurs are superior in, with Microraptor being a better glider and Synornithosaurus being the better runner. And it basically puts them on an even field, and I like that aspect of the chase as it gives that level of uncertainty of which dinosaur will win. The episode ends with a pack of Synornithosaurus taking down a Gigantosaurus with, as the narrator states, a venomous bite, which is now outdated and not actually true according to the latest papers I found. This episode has a very different feel than the first one. It's overall quite a bit slower while still maintaining a relatively fast pace. It also has a lot more small interactions between the dinosaurs. This episode focuses on the last big predatory dinosaurs, Tyrannosaurus in the north, Abelisaurus in the south. It starts with a failed hunt attempt between Despotosaurus and Chasmosaurus. Once again, this helps demystify them, yada yada, I've said it before. However, I do quite like how instead of the usual T-Rex and Triceratops conflict, we get different species from both groups. And honestly, it's nice to see some variation of the famous conflict. After this, we make a pit stop in the Arctic and see Troodon hunting young Edmontosaurus at night, before cutting back to the Despotosaurus, now hunting the Chasmosaurus in a gang. Man, these dinosaur documentaries do really like reusing their concepts, don't they? However, I do like how instead of a coordinated assault like the previous two times we've seen this, it's more like a scramble of the youngsters just trying to get a bite in. I'd also like how we see the contrast between how the two dinosaurs hunt, with the smaller Troodon inflicting as much damage as possible in one assault, then leaving the prey to bleed out, while the bigger Despotosaurus takes down the prey using brute force. We then head to Madagascar and see the infamous cannibal dinosaur Majungasaurus killing, as you would probably expect, another Majungasaurus. The episode ends with the Centrosaurus migration across the river while the Despotosaurus gorge on them. It honestly reminds me a lot of an African river crossing, and it's quite cool that the show took inspiration from that. It also, really enough, reminds me of the Edmontosaurus slaughter. Well, I guess not really enough. It reminds me of the Edmontosaurus slaughter from Watch of the Dinosaurs. The fourth episode starts with us seeing a bunch of Chimerosaurus hunting food in the sand before they are ambushed by a large Predator X that they just managed to escape from by heading into shallow water. We then transition to North America and see a herd of stegosaurus and camptosaurus. I like how the show is expanding on what topics it covers, in this case, symbiotic relationships. Then an allosaurus ambushes the herd, and I quite like how it's shown from the herbivore's point of view, as it gives more attention to the scene, and it even lures the audience into a false sense of security before the allosaurus actually strikes. Honestly, it reminds me a lot of the first night scene from March of the Dinosaurs. The allosaurus, however, fails to capture the running camptosaurus, so instead goes for the stegosaurus, but ends up getting hit by the thagomizer. Later on, we see the allosaurus attempt to hunt the camptosaurus, and once again it manages to lure the audience into a false sense of security. However, without the protection from the stegosaurus, the camptosaurus is easy pickings. I do also like the axe method hypothesis the allosaurus uses to compensate for its rather weak bite. It's really cool to see logical speculation in a documentary. The episode ends with the hunt between Predator X and Chimerosaurus, and without the safety of the shallow water, the Chimerosaurus gets slaughtered by the Predator X. I do like the parallelism of the two perspectives, with both predators initially failing due to an external condition, but once that condition is removed, they both succeed in hunting their prey. It's some nice symbolisms that the show employs. Also, the underwater parts honestly remind me a lot of Whale Killer, and I quite like how, you know, there's some similarities between them. The penultimate episode starts in an Argentinosaurus nest as several nest raiders feast on the babies. This episode focuses on the large sauropods of the Cretaceous. In South America, we see a gang of Maplosaurus tearing chunks of meat from adult Argentinosaurus, and in Africa, we see a tug of war between a Sarcosuchus and a Crocodontosaurus with a young Piranha Titan as their rope. This episode ends with this time lapse of an Argentinosaurus carcass as it is scavenged by the predators, and I like how this sequence kind of shows the food chain of the ecosystem without explicitly stating it. Also, this episode actually has some pretty cool cinematography in some of the shots. I mean, it literally starts with an inside view of a neck cracking. But I also do feel like this one is the most affected by the, how shall I put it, lackluster cinematography style, as there's more scenes where there's not a lot of action. And I'll expand further on that in the conclusion segment. The final episode again focuses on a bunch of different settings. We first see Hat Tech Island, and I like how the cinematography tricks the audience into believing that the Megaerosaurus, I think I pronounced that right, we see are actually large sauropods, but when the large Hatzegopteryx arrive, we see the true scale of the dinosaurs. We then head to New Mexico 95 million years ago and see a conflict between Zuni Tyrannus and Northornicus, but with the real killer actually being deadly bacteria. The final part sees a Gigantoraptor protecting its nest from Electrosaurus and Oviraptors trying to eat the eggs. The series ends with the KT event, and I actually do applaud them for including and explaining the aftermath of the impact. It's still pretty simple, but I am happy we're starting to see more of it. Oh, and there's also a final testimony to the dinosaurs that caps off the show. Overall, Planet Dinosaur is a mixed bag. I think the definite pro is the visuals. The designs are really good and the quality of the CGI is spectacular. It's actually kind of insane how much detail is put into the dinosaurs. It's to the point where in the close-up shots, you can almost distinguish pretty much every single scale from each other. And I don't think I'm exaggerating when I say this is definitely the best looking dinosaur documentary out there. However, the other technical aspects are not as spectacular. For one, the show has this guerrilla style of cinematography, and it can be quite disorienting at times. Like, I feel like I'm watching a Zack Snyder movie with all the quick zooms and stuff. However, I honestly didn't really mind it for the most part, since this is a very action-heavy show, it's more acceptable that way. And yes, I would have definitely preferred more normal cinematography than this, but for what the show actually has, it's at the very least tolerable. And I kinda just got used to it after the first episode. But the big downside with this style is that for scenes that have little to no action, it can be really, really annoying because there's always this constant jitter of the camera. And it just makes it really off-putting as there's virtually nothing going on, and yet the camera is constantly moving. And, you know, this is most apparent in episode 5. Also, the analytical segments were another thing that's a mixed bag. For one, they appear way too often, and because of that, the stories within the episodes don't really have a plot to them. However, the weird thing is that I felt like for the most part they did technically come in places where the story does have a bit of a break, but it's also just really weird because while yes, that's technically somewhat true, it doesn't really feel that way when you're watching the show. But I will say, these segments do make the science more entertaining with all the visual aspects of it. I mean, it is a good thing that the show does emphasize the science. I just don't think this was the best way to do it. Like, when you compare it to something like When Dinosaurs Roamed America, you'll quickly see how that show was conservative with when and where they put the science stuff so that they could include it while also developing the story. And Planet Dinosaur just doesn't really do that. The series also focuses on a very narrow scope when it comes to the subjects being talked about. Most of them revolve around predator-prey relationships, and some that don't are still linked with predator-prey relationships, or I guess more accurately, creature violence. And I want to clear the air on something. I don't have a problem with documentaries where the main subject matter is how one dinosaur could kill another. Now, of course, like most people, I would prefer if broader subjects were talked about that weren't related to killing. But I don't outright despise documentaries that only do dinosaur battles. I mean, I like Truth About Killer Dinosaurs, and the whole premise of that show is how two dinosaurs could kill each other. And my main metric is that I don't oppose that as long as the science behind it is explained, and scenarios makes logical sense, which Planet Dinosaur does. And here's the thing, I understand that dinosaur fighting is very marketable, so I understand why the showrunners would choose this route. But on the other hand, you can still have that while not emphasizing it and putting it in the forefront, which is where this documentary falls flat on. And even to compare it with Truth About Killer Dinosaurs again, yes, that's the I just said the main premise was dinosaurs killing each other, but like, the science was still the main focus. It was about testing it, not showing it. So, to avoid further ranting, because I'm pretty sure I already ranted enough, I'll just say that Planet Dinosaur is not the best, which sucks because the premise of focusing on the latest discoveries is really cool to see how our knowledge of dinosaurs has progressed since the days of Walking With Dinosaurs. But this show delivers it in the wrong way, and kind of just falls back on the trope of dinosaur battles. However, I can't really say I hate or even dislike it, because I did find enjoyment watching it. It just makes me feel very conflicted. Honestly, that's probably the best word I could use to describe this documentary. Conflicted. Alright, tier list times, wow. Quality-wise, I give it a 4.3. I think we can all agree the standout pro is definitely the visuals. They're spectacular, the models are super detailed. And, you know, some of the animation is kind of weird, but, like, that's acceptable. And the other thing is that they do focus a lot on the science, but that's pretty much the only thing, because, the cinematography, was disorienting. The shallow scope of what subjects are covered was kind of disappointing, because you would think that, you know, this came out in 2011, you would think that we would have moved on from the tropes of just dinosaurs killing each other. And also, the analytical segments, I have several problems with them. Like, yes, they do make the science more entertaining, and, you know, they do emphasize the science, but they just appear way too often, and honestly, kinda get annoying at a certain point. I mean, I personally didn't find it annoying, but I can see how some people would find it annoying and kind of repetitive. Entertainment-wise, I give it a 4.5. You know, and to be fair, right, it is very entertaining. Like, I can't say I was bored during it, so at the very least, it has that. And I mean, it's also a very action-heavy show, so that does increase its entertainment value, even if it is somewhat serviceable entertainment. But I guess, you know, the science-y aspects and the way they deliver it does make that part more entertaining as well. Rewatchability-wise, 4.3, it's actually surprisingly quite easy to watch. Like, I don't know, I didn't really feel like I was too much, and that's probably because of the pacing as well. The pacing is also quite fast, so it doesn't really feel like it's 30 minutes. It feels actually quite a lot shorter than 30 minutes. And the thing is, right, even though I say that, you're honestly better off watching better documentaries, because this one just, I don't know, there's like several more better versions of this type of documentary, like Walking With Dinosaurs, per se. And that's just one example, or even Dinosaur Planet, you know? So, yeah, you're better off just watching on the documentary, but I can't outright give it a bad score because, I mean, if you want to rewatch it, you can. And it's, I don't know, it's an easy thing to rewatch. And as for the My Opinion segment, I give it a 3.8. And here's the thing, I want to like it. But the thing is, there's just so many flaws with the series, and it makes me frustrated. Because, like, I want to, like, you know, here's the thing, I don't outright despise any documentaries, or at least any documentaries that I've reviewed. And I like this genre, and I want more dinosaur documentaries that are good. So this one makes me frustrated, because it just misses the mark, even though it was set on the right course. And, you know, I was gonna give it a 4, but if a documentary is making me this frustrated, then I honestly don't think it deserves a 4. And honestly, before I get myself worked up, let's just, get a total, which is, 16.9. Somewhat ironic. And it's at the top of B tier. Yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to leave a like and, subscribe. And, you know, I think after this review, I might have to rework my scores again. Because, yeah, I think I might need to do that. Just because I looked at some of the scores and, I don't think they exactly match. But I probably won't do it for another video just because the last one didn't really do all that well. And, like, it's kind of pointless for me to even do a video on that. But, yeah, I think I might have to adjust the scores in my own time. But, I don't really have anything else to say, so I'll just see you in the next video. Bye.